Before you begin, remove the top cover, battery, wireless LAN module, heatsink, and display panel assembly. Removal. Disconnect the DC in connector cable from its connector on the system board. Disconnect the speaker cable from its connector on the system board. Using minimal force, lift the locking bar up on the USB board ZIF connector and disconnect the USB board ribbon cable from the system board. Remove the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the USB Type-C bracket to the base enclosure. Remove the USB Type-C bracket off of its alignment pins on the base enclosure. Remove the two 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Grasp the left edge of the system board and lift the system board off of its alignment pins on the base enclosure. At an angle, slide the external connectors out of the cutouts in the base enclosure and remove the system board. Replacement. Tow the external connectors on the right side of the system board into the cutouts in the base enclosure and lower the system board onto its alignment pins. Caution. To avoid damage, ensure that all cables are free from being pinched between the system board and base enclosure. Replace the two 3mm P1 Phillips broadhead screws that secure the system board to the base enclosure. Insert the USB board ribbon cable into the USB board ZIF connector on the system board and press the locking bar down to lock the cable into place. Connect the speaker cable into its connector on the system board. Connect the DC in connector cable into its connector on the system board. Place the USB Type-C bracket onto its alignment pins on the base enclosure. Replace the 3mm P1 Phillips head screw that secures the USB Type-C bracket to the base enclosure. Important: after a system board replacement, be sure to complete post-installation tasks as required that may include verifying functionality of the notebook, updating the BIOS, updating DMI and other settings.